Consequences and complications of acute cholecystitis. Usually, resolution in most cases. Under treatment, most cases resolution is spontaneous. Most cases, about 90%. Why? There is a stone obstructing, usually in calcular obstructive jaundice, stone obstructing the cystic duct or neck or Hartmann's pouch. Any obstruction in surgery leading to proximal dilatation. And due to proximal dilatation, usually the stone dislodges and the obstruction is relieved and the infected bile drained to the common bile duct and the inflammation resolution gradually occur. This is the usual consequences. Or chronicity, which is the commonest complication of acute cholecystitis. As usual, if chronic cholecystitis occur, other stone formation leading to other obstruction and the recurrent acute attack of acute cholecystitis. The commonest complication of acute cholecystitis is chronicity and other stone formation. From the vicious circle we said before. Infection may spread. From cholecystitis, infection may spread upward, leading to ascending cholangitis and ascending cholangiohepatitis. Or infection may descend. Infection may descend, leading to descending pancreatitis. Gangrene and perforation is a rare complication. If gangrene and perforation occur, usually localized peritonitis is the rule. Rarely generalized peritonitis. Why? As a protective mechanism, in acute cholecystitis, the policeman of the abdomen, which is the greater omentum, surround the inflammation and the adhesion occur between the gallbladder, greater omentum, duodenum, and the transverse colon. And if perforation occur, it occur in this mass, leading to localized peritonitis and the subphrenic abscess. Rarely, rapid perforation occur into generalized peritoneal cavity with failure of localization leading to generalized peritonitis, very rare. In general, perforation of the gallbladder is rare due to good blood supply. The blood supply of the gallbladder, mainly from cystic artery, but the gallbladder has many additional blood supply from the under surface of the liver. This is the blood supply of the gallbladder, cystic artery mainly, and the many blood vessels passing from the under surface of the liver to the gallbladder. Therefore, gangrene is rare. If gangrene occurs, it occurs where? In the area away from the blood supply, which is the least vascular area, which is the fundus of the gallbladder. Usually, if perforation occurs in the fundus, least vascular. But rarely, perforation may occur in the neck of the gallbladder. Why? In the site of impaction of the stone. The stone presses on the wall, leading to pressure necrosis and the gangrene at the site of impaction in the neck of the gallbladder. Fistula may occur. Fistula may occur. With what? With the surround structure. The gallbladder may perforate into the duodenum, leading to cholecystitis, duodenal fistula, or with any loop of jejunum or intestine, leading to cholecystitis, intestinal fistula, or fistula between the gallbladder and the biliary ducts, called cholecystitis, biliary fistula. If perforation occurs to a surrounding organ leading to a fistula, cholecystitis, duodenal, cholecystitis, intestinal, cholecystitis, colic with the transverse colon, transverse cholecystitis, biliary fistula with the biliary ducts. Finally, and rarely in obstructive jaundice, in cholecystitis, jaundice may occur. How jaundice occurs in cholecystitis? First of all, spread of infection, cholangitis and cholangiohepatitis, leading to jaundice. Cholangitis producing edema. Edema may obstruct the bile ducts. Or, as we take before, in gallbladder stones and in obstructive jaundice, Merezi syndrome. What's Merezi syndrome? A stone in the heart man's pouch. From the lumen leading to obstruction of the gallbladder and the acute cholecystitis. And the stone from outside may compress the common hepatic or common bile duct. This is Merezi syndrome. A stone in the heart man's pouch or cystic duct compress the common hepatic, the end of common hepatic or the beginning of common bile duct, leading to some sort of obstructive jaundice. Therefore, the possibility of jaundice in acute cholecystitis, jaundice is rare, very, very rare in acute cholecystitis, but may occur. Rarely occur due to ascending cholangiohepatitis or edema in the bile ducts or Merezi syndrome. What are the clinical pictures of this patient? When the patient comes to you in your clinic or in the hospital, the first thing calling your attention is the 4F, the incidence. Female, fatty, fertile, 40 to 50. With history of the predisposing factor. What is the predisposing factor? Gallbladder stones and the chronic cholecystitis. History of attacks of biliary pain and discomfort after fatty meal, which is fatty dyspepsia. The main presentation and the initial symptom of acute cholecystitis is biliary pain. Biliary pain is the main and the initial symptom. Lies as any biliary pain in the right hypochondrium, referred to the epigastrium, right shoulder, and the back below the scapula. For more details, this is a gallbladder and covered by serosa. Early, the inflammation leading to distension of the gallbladder. Distension of the gallbladder leading to distension of the visceral peritoneum, the serosa, which is the visceral peritoneum, leading to visceral pain. The visceral pain takes the upper abdomen. the right hypochondrium, epigastrium, and even maybe the left hypochondrium in the upper abdomen. Colicibin due to contraction of the gallbladder. And the gallbladder contract, but tired later on and take a rest. Therefore, the colicibin is intermittent when the gallbladder tired. But this arrest for the gallbladder to recur to contract. Therefore, early there is a visceral vein in the upper abdomen, intermittent colicky diffuse upper abdominal vein. When the inflammation spread from the mucosa to the wall to the serosa, when the inflammation reaches the serosa, which is the visceral peritoneum, irritation of parietal peritoneum occur. When irritation of parietal peritoneum occur, somatic pain is felt, which is pain localized to the right hypochondrium. And according to the nerve supply of the gallbladder, the pain becomes referred, as we know from the anatomy, to the epigastric region, right shoulder, back below the scapula. It should be noticed that the pain in acute cholecystitis persists for more than 6 hours. Why? Because the biliary pain or biliary colic usually relieves spontaneously, biliary colic or biliary pain due to stone migrating in cystic duct or common bile duct. Usually the stone busts and the pain is relieved less than 6 hours. Because if obstruction persists, the condition becomes transformed to infection and to acute cholecystitis. Therefore, pain in acute cholecystitis usually persists more than 6 hours, and this is an important feature in differential diagnosis between biliary colic and the biliary pain, just due to migrating stone passes spontaneously without any inflammation and the acute cholecystitis. The time less than 6 hours or more than 6 hours. In presence of this characteristic type of pain, the patient also has headache and the fever. As we know, in any acute abdomen, reflexly, to give rest to GIT, there is reflex pyrorespasm, producing anorexia, nausea, and vomiting, to avoid eating and to give rest to the tired GIT, in any inflammation of the GIT. Therefore, in acute cholecystitis, sure, there is anorexia, nausea, and vomiting. Finally, and rarely, jaundice may occur in the 3 cases mentioned before. Examination. General examination, the characteristic patient, plus fever. Corresponding to fever, there is tachycardia, and rarely, jaundice. Local examination. Local examination in the right hypochondrium. There is evidence of irritation of parietal peritoneum. When inflammation and there is acute cholecystitis, the inflammation spread to the outer serosa, which is a visceral peritoneum, leading to irritation of parietal peritoneum. If this is the anterior abdominal wall, lined by parietal peritoneum. Therefore, when you palpate the abdomen, like that, you press the anterior abdominal wall, the parietal peritoneum comes with the inflamed serosa of the gallbladder. irritation of parietal peritoneum by the inflamed serosa, leading to tenderness, rebound tenderness, rigidity, and limitation of movement of respiration in the right hypochondria. You should always remember that there are five cardinal manifestation of irritation of parietal peritoneum in any part of the abdomen. Any irritation of parietal peritoneum in any part of the abdomen, in cholecystitis, appendicitis, etc., peritonitis, there is pain, symptom. Signs, tenderness. When you breathe, the anterior abdominal wall, being exaggerated. Rebound tenderness. If you release the pressure suddenly, the anterior abdominal wall comes more with the irritation, leading to rebound tenderness. And due to pain tenderness and rebound tenderness, there is reflex spasm of muscles of the anterior abdominal wall, which is called rigidity. Due to spasm of muscles of the anterior abdominal wall, this leads to limitation of movement of the anterior abdominal wall with respiration in this area, which in case of cholecystitis is the right hypochondria. Then put your hand below the costal margin and ask the patient to take a deep breath. Any normal patient, if you ask to take a deep breath, free respiration, normal. In this patient, ask the patient to take a deep breath. What happened? The patient stopped his breath suddenly. Why? Because during deep inspiration, the diaphragm descend, the liver descend with the gallbladder, and the inflamed tender gallbladder impacted with your hand, leading to reflex arrest of respiration. This is called Murphy's sign, and can be done during ultrasound. Therefore, sonographic ultrasound وعمل sign دهين is diagnostic. Sonographic ultrasound وانا شايف بالسونار وحط ايدي على gallbladder exactly. Put your hand exactly in the gallbladder and ask the patient to take a deep breath. Arrest of respiration. This is more accurate in diagnosis. Also, there is a bowel sign in acute and the chronic cholecystitis, which is area of hyperesthesia in the back below the right scapula, between 9th to 11th rib. Gallbladder mass rarely felt. Why? There is mucosal, there is biosal, not felt usually. Why? Due to presence of tenderness, rebound tenderness, and rigidity, you can't feel the underlying gallbladder swelling from the rigid muscle. And the patient always pull your hand from tenderness and rebound tenderness. This is a clinical picture and complications of acute cholecystitis.